Supercurve honing fans, type 2 diabetes rescued by keto fans and carnivore fans. Bill here. It is Saturday, March the 23rd. I'm going to do a very different shave than what I had done from pretty much the start of me establishing a YouTube channel. I'm going to do a tutorial, okay? In the beginning, I thought, geez, there's so many people around who are doing tutorials, and it becomes and so many people who make shaving videos of different types. You showcase products and you talk about techniques and that. But this is going to be just a little bit different, okay? Tutorial for straight shaving. And this is going to be how I learned, okay? Assuming that you already are a wet shaving hobbyist of some sort, okay, and you understand a brush and soap and that. If you don't, you might be, okay, and it is my hope that you're one of these guys that got tired of your beard and your triple armpits and you just got tired of that because it's too hot or whatever. Maybe your reason for wearing all that facial hair is because, if you do it because it looks cool and you like it, I'm not going to change you on that. But if you are not shaving because of the discomfort that you got out of a shave, that's different. And maybe there's a way for you to find a way to closely groom your facial hair the way many people enjoy. And not suffer. Anyhow, if you got one of the big old beards, get one of these and trim it down first. Okay, so that's one of these things. And I'm not a big fan of straight razor shaving. An inch and a half of facial hair off. And you could do it, but certainly not going to do it starting off. So. Maybe even you are a guy using one of these, okay? If you're using one of these and the stuff that you spray out of a can, go out and get yourself, you can use this, okay? But the first thing I want you to do is go out and get yourself a brush, okay? And some soap, okay? I personally am going to recommend, okay? I like this brush from Sterling. It costs, I don't know, $15 or something. It's not expensive, synthetic, great performer. I probably use this brush more than anything else. And go buy a Sterling flavor. Go buy Deep Blue Sieve. I haven't heard or read anybody that didn't like the smell of this. But this particular soap, and you'll learn how. There's a million videos around how to stir it up and how to whip up a lather. And there's just plenty of stuff on that. And I'm not going to focus on that. What I am going to focus on is whatever you choose. I want you, whatever soap and brush you choose, I want you to stick with it. Whatever your primary shave device, if your primary shave device is this, I want you to stick to it, okay? So and learn straight razor shaving while you still have your current shaving device, because you're going to use both of them. And this method is a method that I learned. It's the way I learned. There was a whole write-up. There was a gentleman, great gentleman, who is now a citizen of South Korea. He moved to Korea years ago on business and found that maintaining his U.S. citizenship was incredibly costly, okay? And he's a U.S. citizen, and he would travel back here. He couldn't rent a car because he didn't have a U.S. address, So a U.S. citizen without a U.S. address has less respect with a rental car company than South Korean citizen who is here visiting, renting a car or whatever. So anyhow, he became a South Korean citizen. He's been out there for years for business, for his livelihood, and great gentleman who taught a lot of people how to straight razor shave. He has some of the finest, unique straight shaving tools in the business. Okay, he just really nice stuff, and it's taught a lot of people. So you can use this. I'm not. Okay, you could use whatever primary tool that you shave with, as long as it's not an electric, as long as it's something with a blade. I'm going to use for this tutorial, I am going to use a Gillette Super Speed. You can get these for $5-$10 on eBay. There was millions and millions of these made. Now, I know my dad used one of these. I remember seeing the twisty thing in the medicine cabinet growing up. But when I learned to shave, and I'm 66, so when I learned to shave, things had come along and the cartridge was starting to make its way in, and my dad had evolved away from this. So my dad, when I started shaving, my dad never was able to coach me with one of these. I don't even know if you would see him. You would buy Track 2. That's what you went and you bought. So at that time, okay. So there may have been other stuff available. I just, you know, the commercials were the Track 2 and that kind of stuff. Anyhow, the blade I'm going to use, and for training, for this tutorial training purposes, I'm gonna suggest, okay, whatever tool you use. Now, if you use a cartridge, I can't tell you how many times to use it, but you'll have a basis for that. For this, I'm gonna say, take a blade and use it twice, no more. Okay, and this is where I'm gonna suggest practice. The blade I'm using is Persona Blue. Okay, there are a lot of people that speak very, very highly of this, and there's one high-end razor maker who I think really likes these and actually ships these with his product. I don't particularly care for them. Okay, they are adequate blades, but for me, they're one or two and they're done. Okay, for me. Okay, I just prefer something different. So whatever device you got, I don't care. The reason I'm using this is because this, to me, is this goes decades that this went along, and this was the tool that millions of Americans shaved with every day, and I think it is probably one of the most intuitive. There's variations on this, but I think this is incredibly intuitive. So I'm using this as my plan number two. Now for the straight, for the open edge tool. Okay, what do I want you to use? Okay, I don't care. Just like I don't care what your backup tool is, but you want the tool you're learning, and you want the backup tool, which you already know how to do. Now you can, if you don't buy a gold dollar. Okay, you can go out and you can buy one of these if you want, and this is one of my favorite razors if you want. But what if you are the person who is just, let's say, exploring whether you want to shave with a straight razor? Do you want to spend this amount of money on this and then go buy a strop and then go buy stones? And do you want to do that? You're maybe not sure yet. Okay. This is a higher end on the replaceable blade, because I'm recommending a replaceable blade. I'm not sure that I would recommend this for this particular tutorial. You could use it. I'm not sure I would recommend it. And while I advocate people who want to use these things, I advocate one of these type things with a ProGuard blade. I don't recommend the ProGuard for somebody who is going to go through a learning session like I'm going to attempt to teach it. So what I am going to recommend, and I don't get any benefit from any vendor of anything that I talk about here. I do, I talk about these things because, I use them and the vendors are good. The tool that I would suggest to use, if you want to learn, if you want to decide, is straight razor shaving for me, go buy one of these. You can get these at thesuperiorshave.com. Okay, he has these for about 10 bucks. Okay, and this is, you may, if you're in another part of the world or country, this is a Focus R21 Evo, E-V-O. You got to get that or you will not get this little plastic insert in here. There'll be a metal slide in here, and I'll show you why I like this plastic insert. Now, why do I like this tool, and why do I wish I'd have got this tool? Because with this tool, I could, without a blade in here, I could figure, okay, well, how am I going to do this? How am I going to, because that's a big thing. You know, if you have never shaved with a straight razor, okay, and I allowed in my straight razor training, okay, I allowed 1 hour. I started off with 1 hour per day, and I committed to 100 days. It tapered off to less than that, pretty quick in that. But if you're going to pick up one of these and begin to say, you know, okay, and you're thinking about your angle and you're thinking about a lot of stuff, this is not what you want to be able to adjust with. Something like this, and I know people have gotten gold dollars and dulled them and done that kind of stuff, so you can try to learn your angles and learn your grip and your stretching. And the technique part of shaving is going to come a little bit after the hardware thing, where I'm going to get into that. The principle that I go on, okay, is number one, a good lather, okay? And that's why I want, for whatever duration you want to do, use the same stuff. Don't change up. So guys like me and guys like a lot of my friends, we shave with different stuff all the time, and we're experienced, and we enjoy that because we enjoy the variety and we enjoy going through it. I know people who eventually evolved to where they just use the same thing all the time, even though they've got lots and lots of stuff. Okay, so you're going to get one of these, and you're going to start to, and you can look at a million shave videos of straight razors and how people, different people use their grips and that kind of stuff, and begin to figure that out without ever worrying about whether you're going to cut yourself. That's another reason I like this. You can learn, you know, do you want two fingers? Do you want this? Do you want this? You know, are you going to go like this? Are you going to, you know, how are you going to hold this against your face? The second principle of shaving for me is, after a good lather, is sharp steel. And that's why I'm saying, for this, change the blade every other day. Just for the startup, okay? And for this, I'm gonna say, change the blade every other day. It's not gonna cost you a bunch of money. Okay, so if you go down to the Superior Shave and you buy one of these from the Superior Shave for $8 or $10 or whatever they are, okay, the guy is not making a fortune on, although people have made a lot of bad press about him because he sells sharpening stones. It's like, you know, so you're a straight razor fan and you don't want a guy selling sharpening stones? Give me a break. Anyhow, he does sell these. I don't know, for $10, how much money is in that? Not that much. So you could also, while you're down there, buy something else. You could buy a pack of blades. If you don't have any of these type of blades laying around, double-edged blades laying around, buy a pack of blades. If you want to buy a soap, I highly recommend the Dovo soap. They're made by Ariana and Evans. And aftershave, you could do that, and you could use that for this thing. So we're going to load this up, okay? And this is going to be the shave tool. This has some nice little holding mechanisms for the blade when you get one of these. Another option is, and the reason I like this is, see how this has like a recess? Let's put the blade in there, okay? So you could get a Vanta, which will use a whole blade, or I think there's a Vanta that uses a half a blade. These are not hard to snap, okay? And you take half of these, and so if this blade costs you a dime, okay, it's a nickel for a half a blade, and then if you use it 2 days, it's 2.5 cents. Okay, so 2.5 cents for a shave with a $10 tool, to me, becomes one of the most cost effective shaves that money can buy. Okay, and then you're gonna put this in here, and this is gonna have like these little registration pins in the corner and a little bottom out piece on there. And it's gonna go in there, and you're gonna close it, and it is gonna seat, make sure it's seated. And then all this thing does is it slides into this metal holder. And what you have is you have a recessed blade with the corners guarded. Don't buy, and I didn't bring the example in here, I was going to, don't buy one of these things where the blade sticks way out. There's you can see these things on eBay and Amazon, and they fashion hefty things that have one, and they kind of look like this, and they're kind of cool, and you kind of think, well, why should I have that? I could have that. That's the same as, no, it's not the same. Okay, it's don't buy one of those. I have one. Okay, get one of these. Or a Vanta, or if you want to use something else, do use something else. It is going to be very difficult if you do choose. And I know people, I have a good friend who committed to learning straight razor shaving. He just one day changed over and he decided to take on everything, stropping, honing, shaving, everything. This is going to help you determine, do you want to shave with a straight razor? And the tutorial I learned after the principles, sharp steel, lowest angle, lightest touch, okay, stretch the skin. If you remember, good soap, sharp steel, lowest angle, lightest touch, stretch the skin. You'll have the basics of whatever it is you need to use, and you should already be doing that with this if you get irritation-free shaves. Okay, so if you're wanting to learn, okay, the first thing I do, okay, is I'll do it for both sides, okay? I go almost perpendicular. I don't think of so many degrees of angle, and there's lots of good straight razor tutorials that are out there that'll talk about why you want about a certain degree angle. Well, what I do is I kind of get to the point where I'm looking around and I'm looking to where I'm going to touch, and I'm kind of very flat and just tip up and start moving at the same time with the lightest touch. Just almost skimming the soap off, okay? And for the first time, that's what I want you to do. First shave, okay? And then do that on the other side. Now, you may want to try the cross-handed thing. You may, hopefully you've loaded the blade up and you've done the cross-handed thing, okay? So that is your first experience straight shaving. We're done. Day one with that tool. And then what we do is we pick up our alternate tool. That we have shaved with every other time. This is making the assumption that you are a three-pass shaver. If not, just starting off with, if you're a two-pass shaver, then you're going to do another pass with this tool. But for the first time, you have done this, and we're done for today. My mentor, Keith Max, that's kind of the way he taught it, okay? And you don't make a video. You know, if the kids are fighting out there, you don't do this. If there's something going on, you don't do it. If the pets are running around, you don't do this. What you do when you have your straight razor in your hand, you concentrate on, okay, a little bit of stretch the skin, lowest angle, lightest touch, and you're going to go. Now, for most people, that is a with the grain stroke or with the grain pass. And that's what I'm recommending. Then you're done. Okay. So, and you do that, exactly that. Now, you'll advance pretty quickly to where you'll do that same thing on the second pass and, you know, and you'll advance a little bit. Okay, but first time, that's all I want you to do. I don't want you to try and do the mustache or the chin. I don't want you to try and do anything other than learn the feel of the tool in your hand and the feel of the blade on your face. Now you'll get a little bit different blade feel from this and a little bit different sensation because this is pretty light, but it's pretty safe to do that. And you're not gonna have to worry about going to work with all these little pieces of cotton balls all over because you done cut yourself because you wanted to be a badass and learn how to straight shave. Okay? So, second shave, second day, okay, you're gonna do exactly that same thing. And then what you may wanna do, okay, now I'm gonna do a cross pass here with this. You know what? Whether you do a cross pass here, and some people go, I found this motion very difficult for me, and I usually go cross going outwards, which is more with the grain. But watch a bunch of people and see what you want to do, and do this with your blanket. Figure out how you want to do and how you want to advance. Now, for me, all right. Let me just do this. So that could be your second move. And around here where there's wrinkles and this can get you. So you might want to leave this and go, because I initially had a circle beard or goatee, and I would start here. And when I started shaving, I didn't have to straight shave into here. Now I kind of go in. That's a little bit more tricky, so stay away from that area. So if this is your second, go from a safe area out. Now, underneath the neck, a lot of people, their hair grows directly down, and you can do a directly north to south on the thing. Stay away from the curve here, okay? But get the neck way up, lowest angle. Now for me, this right down here, the hair is kind of growing up that way, so that's against the grain for me. So that's why I'm kind of stopping here. Okay. If you're like me, your second pass could be learning to do this. Little stretch on the skin, lowest angle. I'm going to leave this alone. And would I get something there? I got some blood. Yeah, I'm doing a tutorial and I'm bleeding. So there you have next steps after that first partial shave. This is a very tricky place around here, okay, where you have that the loose part of the neck and the tightness from the chin. Stay away from that with your straight razor for now. So whatever method you use, and around the mouth is going to be a whole nother thing, but by that either learning that initial on the open part of the cheeks, okay, where there's no trick areas. Some people have hollows in the neck, certainly under here. If you have a protruding Adam's apple, that's awful tricky. So shave on the easiest areas with the open edge tool and learn how to use that. So that is how, and for me, I'll go ahead and I'm going to finish the shave up open blade with an against the grain pass. I'll come in on time on, I usually try to limit my videos to 30 minutes. And I'm sloshing, and you know, you'll learn and if you're maybe you're one of these bearded guys and you decide, or maybe you're a cartridge guy and you decide you want to pick this up at the same time. Okay, stay with this. I'm going to ask you to stay with it, whatever you're doing, for 1 month, or try for a week. Maybe a week, maybe 2 weeks. You say, this ain't for me. I don't want to do this. Okay, but don't advance, don't change. Use the same stuff repeatedly. And the idea is that we're going to acclimate and we're going to decide whether we want to do this on a long-term basis or not. So this is I got some blood going, don't have my owl block in here. I don't think I cut myself. I didn't feel it. I might have had a blemish there. And things like doing this, like I'm here. Are things that as you learn and as you advance, you'll get used to it. And you could use this for a month, 2 months, 3 months, that 100 shaves, you could do it. I know a guy who had one of these and he did 100 shaves with this and he learned and he was very grateful. That he took the time to do that. That was never his plan to pick up a true straight and get into the expense and the need to hone and strop. Many people, myself included, consider the against the grain, what they call the fool's pass against the grain under the nose, to be probably the most advanced shaving stroke. And don't do that until you are totally comfortable with the rest of your handling of the open edge tool. Now, what I'm feeling with just the water, and this is not unusual for me with a Persona, okay? I would shave with them and I would continue with them, okay? I have my blade preferences. And if you go to any shave forum and you say, hey, I'm thinking about taking up straight razor shaving, what do you recommend? Well, they'll send you to a thread that'll be like 500 pages long, or you'll have 500 or 1,000 guys telling you 500 or 1,000 different things. Do this, do that, get this, get that. Because I would say, what I would say is you do what I'm telling you to do here and what I'm demonstrating. Okay, no, you want a real straight. You don't want, you know, because a Chevette can cut you, okay? I don't particularly like Persona blades. There's other blades I have my preferences, but I can shave with them. And on three passes, I did not really get the result that I wanted. So if, and this is part of the thing, the tool you're familiar with what you end your shave up with, is what you use to back up. Back up your shave with and finish out your same shave so that you have a shave that you're comfortable with. And the principles that I'm applying, the principles that I talked about, apply here to sharpest steel, sharp steel, okay? Not necessarily the sharp steel, okay? It's got to be sharp enough. You'll know what it is, okay? Lowest angle, lightest, good soap, lowest angle, lightest touch, stretch the skin. And there are all kind of advanced techniques that you'll apply and you'll use, and just watch other people. Doing straight shaves. And you will get it. So that's the tutorial for the first week or so, anyhow. I just don't think that's not a cut. Leanne and I always talk about it. They bleed when I'm done, I cut. So that's an acceptable shave for me. Not my best. I've done better with all of these tools. I've done better. I don't know. I would have to work with the Personas more, but I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, it's a good shave. It's not a poor shave. It's a good shave. And then get a good aftershave if you haven't done that. I like to use a witch hazel or a little bit of a cream. And that was Sterling Unscented. And then I also like to use an alcohol-based aftershave, okay? So, and if you went to Sterling and you bought the brush and, you know, by Deep Lucy, and if you don't like it, if you don't like the smell of it, if you don't think it is one of the most glorious stanks on the face of the earth, you can send it to me, I'll use it. So that's the tutorial. I hope I'll go a little bit further with this if I need to. Okay. I did have, I forgot the name of the gent that I believe he is largely a hobby shaver that has not taken up straights, that has seen that and he's yearning for that. Okay. So if there are people, and look at the mess I made. If there are people who want me to try and further this tutorial as a next step after here, I don't think I need to. I think once you pick up the tool and you learn the feel of the tool, whatever, you know, if you decide that this is the tool or this is the tool, and you decide whatever, you'll get the feel of that. And by taking those basic things where on the flat parts of your face, where you learn to go across and with and maybe against a little bit, you'll learn the handling of that, and then you'll naturally advance. And once you get the hand how you're going to hold, it's a little bit easier to figure how am I going to go around the nose and the mouth, and how am I going to get around the big Adam's apple I've got, or the hollow that I may have, or wrinkles or whatever. You'll learn. Okay, so I hope that's been helpful to somebody. Hope you all have a great week. This is Bill. Out. Bye.